Klaus Kirstein, the founder of Nonstop Night and Royal Revolt publisher Flare Games, is looking to unite free-to-play devs and service providers under the banner of new company Phoenix Games. Phoenix specifically wants to bring together small to mid-size game companies, which Kirstein claims often struggle to access capital and liquidity for their founders, to help them compete in an increasingly competitive market. To that end, the company is preparing to make multiple acquisitions in the coming months, and although it's largely targeting free-to-play devs with a mobile leaning, will apparently chase any opportunities that fit into its ever-evolving ecosystem. Unlike a traditional publisher, Kirstein claims Phoenix will promote a more long-term strategic approach that allows every company under its umbrella to benefit from and share in each other's success. Being part of Phoenix will offer such teams and their founders wherever in the world they are based the chance to better compete with the industry's biggest names by pooling their strengths, creating for themselves a far less perilous road to profitability, explains a press release. Although the finer points of Phoenix's sharing is caring business plan are being kept under wraps for now, we can expect to hear more in the months ahead. The 2019 Game Developers Conference has released the results of the 7th Annual State of the Industry Survey, revealing trends in the game industry ahead of GD 2019 in March. The survey compiles responses from nearly 4,000 game developers, and reflects that nearly half of game developers support game industry unionization, as well as uncertainty around Steam's revenue sharing model, and insights into the amount of time developers have spent working overtime hours in so-called crunch. The State of the Industry Survey is the 7th entry in the ongoing series of yearly reports and serves as a snapshot of the game industry, illustrating industry trends ahead of DD 2019. Organized by UPM, DD 2019 takes place March 18-22 at the Moscow Convention Center in San Francisco, California. Nearly half of game industry professionals think game industry workers should unionize. Unionization is a hot topic in the game industry these days, and nearly half of the game industry professionals surveyed think it's a good idea. When asked whether they thought game industry workers should unionize, 47% said yes, 26% said maybe, 16% said no, and 11% said they did not know. However, when asked whether they think video game workers actually will unionize, only 21% said yes. The largest share, 39%, gave an uncertain maybe. 25% of respondents said they do not think it will happen, and 15% said that they do not know. It is critical that people who work in games are able to maintain a healthy lifestyle, live normal lives, and be able to enjoy a high quality of life that will work out for their spouses and families, wrote one respondent. But there is too much supply, too many people want into the industry, claimed another. Those who unionize will be shoved out of the way as companies hire those with fewer demands. Steam is the storefront to beat on PC, but some devs thrive on smaller competitors. Given how many notable new game storefronts debuted in 2018, such as the Epic Games Store and Discord Store, this year, survey respondents had the option to disclose which PC Mac game storefronts they sell their games on, and what percentage of their platform sales came from each. As expected, the most popular answer was Steam, with roughly 47% of those who responded to this question saying that they sell games on Valve's storefront. Of the respondents who said they sell their games on Steam, the majority, 55%, say Steam accounts for 75-100% of their sales revenue, and another 17% say it makes up 50-75% of their total revenue. Conversely,
GOG,
Humble, and Discord each accounted for less than 10% of revenues earned by a notable majority of the respondents who sell games there. Interestingly, while indie-centric Star Edge had a similar ratio, 52% of devs who use its AI generates less than 10% of their revenues. It also had a surprisingly high number of respondents, 28%, who said it accounts for 75-100% of their earnings. This shows that ITCH's open approach have likely attracted smaller indies who sell exclusively on it. Most game makers are not sure Steam still justifies its 30% cut. In light of how competition is heating up for PC games marketplaces, the survey also asked respondents whether they felt that Steaming its current farm justifies a 30% cut of their game's revenue, which it currently takes. Only 6% said yes, and 17% said maybe. The rest either said no or were not sure, with the largest share, 32%, saying Steam currently does not justify Valve's revenue share. 27% said such a large cut probably is not justified, and 17% said they just did not know. Take less revenue from sales and curate their store better for visibility for real games, is what one respondent wrote when we asked what features respondents felt Steam could add to better serve developers. Better support for amateur, hobbyist, and independent creators, wrote another. More fostering of things like game jams and actual development communities to be created on the platform. Nearly half of game makers work over 40 hours a week on games. To get a sense of the current labor conditions in the game industry, the State of the Industry survey incorporated questions asking game developers from corporate to indie to share their average work hours in a week in the past 12 months, incorporated including all respondents. The results look fairly balanced, since half of respondents, 35%, say they spend more than 40 hours a week working on games, and 56% said they worked 40 hours or less. The most common work week proved to be 36-40 hours per week, with 25% of respondents saying that was their average. 21% of respondents said they worked on games 41-45 hours per week on average, and 17% said they averaged 0-20 hours per week on games, with a number of this likely being part-time or hobbyist workers. However, 3% of respondents said they averaged over 60 hours of work per week on games, and 5% said they averaged 51-60 hours. The survey also asked about maximum hours per week work during a single week in the last 12 months. While the largest response was 51-60 hours in a single week, responses range as high as more than 110 hours in a week, 15%, with a small spike at 76-80 hours in a week, 6%. Suggesting that deadline-related crunch can go far beyond normal working hours. With new consoles rumored, some devs are making games for unannounced platforms. With the current generation of now several years into their cycle, the 2019 survey now incorporates questions asking respondents whether or not they are developing their next game for any upcoming unannounced platforms. Predictably, very few, under the 100, or less than 2% of respondents said their next game is being designed exclusively for an unannounced platform. 16% said their next game is being developed for both existing and upcoming unannounced platforms, and the largest share, 36%, said their next game is only coming to existing platforms. 36% said they did not know at this time. The full survey, which includes lots more detail on what game platforms developers are creating for
iOS, VS,
Android, and a multitude of other facts and detail, can be downloaded for free here. Bring your team to GD.